Oh boy, it's a time to cast the Super Mario movie.
You mean the Super Mario Bros movie.
Do not correct me, Luigi. I am never wrong.
Here's our first audition. Spaceship.
Wow, you're stupid. Let me think, do we have any stupid characters?
Yeah, you can play Luigi.
Aw, Mario.
Oh man, that's not fair.
Here's our next audition.
I like to hold hands with a rabbit.
Wow, you're really weird.
You can play Toad.
What? Spaceship? All right, here's our next audition.
Hey, I train dinosaurs.
Wow, I've been training dinosaurs since I was a baby.
Actually, I think the dinosaurs trained you.
I also fly through space and fight aliens.
Wow, he is so cool. He reminds me of someone else who is cool.
I know. You can play me, Mario.
Actually, Mario, I was thinking Jack Black could play you.
What? That short, fat, hairy guy? No, he can play Bowser. Come on, Chris Pratt, let's go make out. Go do Mario stuff. Yahoo!
Greetings, friends. Sonic Toast here. So happy to have the 5-inch Super Mario movie figures finally in my possession. And we're going to be reviewing Mario today. Now, one thing I want to hop into right away is how nice these boxes are. Seriously, these action figures are $10 more than a normal Mario action figure. They are $20 instead of $10. And honestly, I think $12 of that is just going towards the box. So first of all, we have these really nice pictures of the figures on the sides. But not only are they nice looking, the character themselves is very smooth and glossy compared to the black part of the box. Same with the letters here are a little bit different texture. Now, if we look on the other side of the box, we also have these great pictures of the full body shot of the action figure, and it is very smooth also. Same with the logo, it is textured. It is really, really nice. On the back, same thing we got here. We have the nice picture of the action figure. Also, all these designs, these question mark blocks and mushrooms in the background, are all very smooth, shiny, nice, along with the logo. This is just a very superb box, and it is for all of the characters. Here, we'll look at the sides for all of them. So you can see here, these boxes are just fantastic, and that might be why these action figures are so expensive compared to the normal Mario action figures. This might be Jack specific, trying to get more into the collector's game with these big old boxes and these very detailed action figures, you know, something that you would see from like Super 7, NECA, Kid Robot, you know, companies like that. But yeah, this is still Jack specific. Even though these boxes are really nice, they are mostly empty. Makes me think of when Popco started selling their Mario toys in bigger boxes and were charging like $5 extra than they used to when they started coming in this size box. Because when a box is this big, yes, you are paying for the cardboard. Anyway, another cool thing though about these figures is the eyes. Notice how the eyes just follow you? Mario, Luigi, and Peach all do this. Isn't that crazy? Anyway, so that is enough about going on about the box and the price. Let's get the figure open. And here he is, Movie Mario. Whoops, wrong one. There we go, the Movie Mario action figure from Jack's Pacific. Now this guy looks fantastic. A lot of great detail has gone into his sculpt. You can see from the stitching around the M on his hat to the stitching on top of his hat. We can see a lot of extra texture in his hair and in his mustache. And then the eyes that go deep into the figure, giving him that feature that lets him look at you no matter what angle you are looking at him. The denim on his overalls is also really cool looking. We got stitching on the sides. There's stitching down his butt crack, and the wrinkles on his shirt look great. Overall, I'd say Jax outdid themselves with the sculpt on this figure. Now Mario comes with a plunger, which is the perfect accessory for unclogging the nasty poops out of your toilet. You know, it's funny because the original Movie Mario action figure also came with a plunger, except it was spring-loaded. Now, this is a monkey wrench. This came with Luigi. I can't seem to find my Mario's plunger, my old Mario's plunger. I know I have it somewhere, but anyway, yeah, it had this. It could do this. See? that. Anyway, they also came with these belts, these little removable utility belts, tool belts. Anyway, that's just a piece of history there. Thank you, Bob Hoskins. You can go. Aside from the accessory and the sculpt, he also seems to have some really good articulation here. Definitely a step up from the normal Jack-specific Mario figures. We got the ball joints in the legs and in the shoulders. We have, I think these are ball joint elbows or double jointed elbows, twisting wrists, no bend in the wrist, but we do have a twist at the thigh, we have a bend in the knee, and we have all kinds of articulation in the foot. We have a twist at the waist, and then we have the head, which turns, you know, left and right, and it can kind of go a little bit up, but not really. Overall, for a Mario figure, superb. Possibly one of the most articulated Mario figures we have ever gotten. Now, here's something I'm not crazy about, and that is the proportions. I don't like that they decided to go bigger than the standard Jack-specific Mario figures. I kind of wish they made the movie figures in the same proportions. Why? I just think they already have this proportion established so well that it's ridiculous to all of a sudden just go bigger. I mean, with the Sonic movie figures, they made the movie ones the same size as the standard video game Sonic figures. So I don't know why they've decided to go bigger with Mario. Here is movie Mario next to movie Sonic. You can see Mario does seem unproportionately big compared to the proportions we are used to. However, in the movies, Mario is a human and Sonic is a hedgehog. And we know that Sonic is much shorter than a human in the movies. And Mario is a short human, so, you know, Sonic wouldn't be as short as he is next to, like, Tom, you know, James Marsden. But in a crazy way, I almost feel like this might work in this movie continuity, as if these two movies were in the same continuity, which I guess there are some kind of some clues and references to the Sonic movie in the Mario advertisements, but who knows. And here's Bob Hoskins Mario again. You know what else is funny and just kind of coincidental is in the early Sonic movie concepts, they wanted Chris Pratt to be Sonic's co-star as the part of Tom Wachowski. I guess Chris Pratt preferred Mario over Sonic. Overall, friends, I must say this movie Mario figure is superb in terms of his posability, in terms of his sculpt, in terms of just being solid, and just overall a quality figure. Yes, there are some things I don't like, such as the high price point, which, like I said, you're mostly just paying for the box. And I don't like the proportions, but that's just me being picky as a collector, wanting all my figures to be in, you know, the same size as each other. But overall, I think this is a great figure, and I am very, very happy with it. Tell me what you think in the comments section below. Have a fantastic day, and toast!